My beloved brothers and sisters, one of the greatest favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us is the fact that He sent to us the chosen messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة.
Indeed, Allah has favored the believers when He sent to them from amongst them the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, reciting the verses, purifying, cleansing, teaching them, guiding them, etc., etc. Every goodness that we have, Allah chose to give it to us through the blessed messenger who came with the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't we owe Allah? Don't we owe Allah the gratitude? And in order to show that gratitude to Allah, He wants us to constantly recognize the status and the value of the messenger whom He sent, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So much so that if the name of that messenger is said, and we intentionally do not say, may peace be upon him, O sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are at fault. In fact, we would be earning and invoking upon ourselves the wrath of Allah. May Allah protect us. Don't ever be ashamed of saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or may peace be upon him, the moment you hear the name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because by recognizing the favor of Allah upon the messenger of Allah, you are actually doing a favor to yourself. Who is the bestower of favor? Is it you and I, or is it Allah? It is Allah. Some have more wealth, some have greater health, some have good looks, some have authority, some have a condition that is very, very good. Where did it come from? When we acknowledge that the giver is Allah, it actually removes from our hearts jealousy and envy, because we know it is Allah who gave. I don't need to be jealous of someone whom Allah has given more than me in knowledge, in authority, in wealth, in looks, in anything else. The reason is, it was Allah who chose. By being jealous of someone, you are actually defying Allah, who is the giver. So the greatest of gifts was given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we were favored by the greatest blessing upon us, whether we understand it or not, is actually the fact that we are mu'mineen. I'm sure the believers understand that. We believe in Allah. We believe in the messenger. Islam came with beautiful teachings to worship Allah alone. To worship Allah alone without associating partners with your maker, and with great discipline. This is why when people look at Islam, they see it to be a very disciplined religion. Tell me, who would be behaving in a better way? Those who are disciplined or those who are not? Those who have high morals and values or those who don't? May Allah help us to protect our values and our morals. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on the straight and narrow. Ameen. My beloved brothers and sisters, if I were to ask you, who do you love the most? The true answer would be, from amongst us as mankind, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من نفسه وولده ووالده والناس أجمعين.
None of you are considered true believers until you love the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he was speaking, so he said, until you love me more than you love not only your fathers and your children and all the people, but even yourself.
وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ.
Whatever the messenger has instructed you, obey it. Whatever he has prohibited, stay away from it and be conscious of Allah. MashaAllah.
وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ.
It is not for a true believing male or female that when Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have declared something, that they think they have a choice in that regard. True believers know, I don't have a choice, I follow, and I will follow Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blindly. La ilaha illallah. For as long as I know the Messenger said this, it is for me. For as long as I know Allah said this, it is for me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deeper understanding. My beloved brothers and sisters, as I told you, to be a true believer, you have to love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything and anyone else. However, my brothers and sisters, let me take you into your own lives and my life. When we love our spouse, our parents, our children, our siblings and others, what happens? We try to make them happy. They say, if you want to get a big man to do something, talk to the wife. La ilaha illallah. If he loves his wife, she can make him do what you could not make him do in 1 year, in 1 minute. La ilaha illallah. I think here in Nigeria, we know exactly what I am referring to. Yes, we love our spouses, our family members. If they are asking us to do something, what would we do? We would do it. It's okay. For as long as it is not in the disobedience of Allah. Man is so weak that sometimes to prove his love to another person or a spouse or someone whom they are not even supposed to be having a relationship with, at times they might end up doing something haram to please a human in the displeasure of Allah. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to us, man arda an-nas bi sakhatillahi sakhita Allahu anhu wa askhata anhu an-nas. وَمَنْ أَرْضَ اللَّهَ بِسَخَطِ النَّاسِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَأَرْضَى عَنْهُ النَّاسِ. La ilaha illallah. Whoever pleases mankind through the displeasure of Allah, they will earn the displeasure of Allah. And very soon the people will also be displeased. Those whom you were trying to please will also be displeased. And whosoever pleases Allah while the people have become displeased due to that, Allah is pleased with that person, and sooner or later the people will also be happy and pleased, even though they may have been displeased at some point. May Allah protect us. So when we love, that love is closely depicted by how we follow and how we listen to the loved and the beloved. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is our duty towards him? If we were in love with Allah and in love with the messenger, how should we show that love? It is a question, because today, when people want to show their love and joy and happiness, what do? Those who do not believe, they might party all night in order to say, I am happy today. I love my spouse. It is our 10th anniversary, 20th anniversary, 50th anniversary. There is alcohol. There is haram. There is so much disobedience of Allah. There is immorality in dress, in everything else, whatever it may be, and people don't even care for them, we are rejoicing. Is that celebration in the displeasure of Allah? You know that it is not. I know that it is not. It is actually insulting Allah, insulting the messenger, insulting what Allah has blessed you with. People say, I have turned 50 years old. My brother, you are now 1 year closer to your grave. La ilaha illallah. If you are to thank Allah for it, alhamdulillah. If you are to make dua to Allah for it, alhamdulillah. If you are to become more conscious on that day, alhamdulillah. If you are to reflect on that day to say, I am becoming older, mashallah, or I thank Allah for what He has bestowed upon me, and I do not want to lose focus from that which is to come, then alhamdulillah. But if you are to rejoice in the displeasure of Allah, then la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is man. When we want to show joy and love, and we want to show happiness and gratitude, sometimes we forget Allah. Allah has given us the best days of rejoicing in the year. Do you know which days they are? There are 2 days. They are known as Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Every time Allah gives us a day or an occasion of happiness and rejoicing, wallahi, He asks us to engage in an extra act of worship. Eid al-Adha, we have an extra salah known as Salatul Eid. We have a khutbah known as the reminder of the day of Eid, right? When it comes to the day of marriage, it's a very happy day. We should be coming to the masjid and at least listen to a khutbah of that nikah, right? At least listen to a few good words. It is an act of worship, subhanallah. When we have other good days, happy days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do something for Him. Look at a Friday. It is the Eid al-Usbu'. It is the happy day of the week. What do we have? We have a little lecture, mashallah. It's something extra. We listen to a few good words for a few minutes. We are reminded, we feel motivated, we reflect, we change ourselves for the better, we make good resolutions and we leave. That is what Jumu'ah is all about. We find out about our fellow brothers and sisters. Do you know that that is one of the duties upon us? Al-Jumu'atu wal-Jama'ah. You know, your gathering on a Friday and the gathering of the people is very important. If I see you once a week at least, and I'm supposed to be seeing you more than a few times a day, but if it is once a week for some reason that we have maybe a bigger masjid that we attend, when I don't see you one of the weeks and I know that you are here all the time, I ask about you. I haven't seen you. Are you okay? I will call. Is this man okay? Is this sister fine? Is this person okay? Is there something I can do? That is a true believer. That is true love and concern for one another. Another point of true love and concern in Islam, تسلم على كل من عرفت ومن لم تعرف. You need to greet, but the greeting, Allah is watching. Do you only greet those you know, or do you also greet the others whom you don't know? La ilaha illallah. I may not know you personally. When I come in, do I greet you? Do I talk to you? Do I acknowledge you? La ilaha illallah. One of my good friends, may Allah give him Jannatul Firdaus, whenever I visited Cape Town, he was always with me, always by my side. Last week, he went to Madina Munawwara. He went to the front. He made salam ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He suffered a heart attack. A little time later, he passed away. May Allah give him Jannatul Firdaus. He was in Madina Munawwara with very, very few family members. Very few. But when his janaza went, many people followed that janaza. Subhanallah. You know, if someone were to pass away, we would all follow the janaza at times and mostly even if we didn't know, because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, whoever fulfills that salah of janaza will have one mountain of reward. And if you are to follow it up to the burial, you will have two mountains of reward. I want that mountain and you want it too. May Allah grant us mountains of reward. My brothers and my sisters, if we cared for each other in our lives, The same way we care for the janazah after its death, we would solve half the problems of this ummah. We would solve half the problems of this ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen us. Now let's get to the crux of the matter.
قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ
Allah is instructing His messenger to tell us, if you love Allah, what should you be doing? I want to know. I love Allah. Allah gave me the life I have, everything I have, the faculties I have, the eyes, the ears, the nose, the fingers, the tongue, the legs. To start with, within myself, every single organ. If one organ goes wrong, it is a small qiyamah for us. One organ goes wrong, it is a huge problem for us. My beloved brothers and sisters, we love Allah. We thank Allah. We are pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. When we want to prove that love for Allah, do you know what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us? He says, if you were to follow me, you would earn the love of Allah. And Allah tells this to us in the Quran as well. Subhanallah. Allah tells it to us in the Quran as well. That if you are claiming to love Allah, so follow the messenger. Peace be upon him. And in return, Allah will love you and he will forgive your shortcomings. For indeed, he is most forgiving, most merciful. La ilaha illallah. I want you to take this verse back home. To prove your love for Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you need to prove that you are following what was sent by Allah through the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but you are drinking alcohol? What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but you are gambling? What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but you are engaged in adultery that you just not quitting? What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but you cannot quit the pornography? What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but your dress code is not modest? What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, but your mouth is filthy with bad, abusive, hurtful, dirty, false, deceptive words? La ilaha illallah. What is the point of saying, I love the Messenger, when we don't follow what the Messenger said? As he has said, the best from amongst you is those, or the one who is best to his spouse, and we are the worst to our spouses, but we just say, I love the Messenger. La ilaha illallah. My brothers and sisters, let's be careful regarding paying lip service to some statements, when in reality we are far away and we are not even trying to come near. May Allah forgive us. We have just crossed the month of Rabi' al-Awwal, a very, very important month of the Islamic calendar. We are so honored that Allah blessed us with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was born in that month. He passed away in that month. It is an absolutely amazing month. Every Muslim feels the joy in his heart that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to us. I have just recited the verse right at the beginning. I spoke about that. But my brothers and sisters, remember, it is not all about jumping and paying lip service when our lives are far away from the path of the same messenger. It is one of the traps of shaitan to make you pay lip service on one day, yet you cannot quit smoking a cigarette, let alone anything else. May Allah strengthen those who are smoking cigarettes to cut that habit for the sake of Allah and even for their own health's sake. Ameen. One day when I said that, there was a brother in the crowd in one of the masjids who came to me later. He said, Sheikh, today you prayed for the destruction of my business. I said, what is your business? He says, I sell cigarettes. I said, my brother, may Allah forgive all of us. I did not intend that, but what is said and what was said had to be said. Take it or leave it. The message is clear. It's up to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to follow the best of paths. Wallahi, if the doctor was to tell you, you would quit it. But when Allah says it, we still think 2, 3, 4 times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. So my beloved brothers, my sisters, remember one thing. If you want to know whether you really love the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you only need to look at your lifestyle. That's it. Look at what you do. Look at your ibadah. Do you get up for salah? That is fajr salah, let alone the tahajjud. If you get up for tahajjud, inshallah, it is better. And that salah that you get up for should reflect on your tongue. A mu'min has a clean, polite, beautiful, respectful tongue at all times. My beloved youth who are listening to me today, clean your tongue. Clean your tongue. Say respectful words. Be polite. Be honorable. Command the respect by respecting yourself to begin with. Automatically people will know you are respectful. Dress in a way that if the messenger were to glance towards you, he would be proud of the way you are dressing and speaking and what you are doing. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. May Allah strengthen us. That is true love. Don't you agree? That is true love. We love the messenger. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast on a Monday. When he was asked about that fasting on a Monday, he said, that was the day I was born, so I would like to fast on that day. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Do we fast on a Monday and a Thursday? That is the love of the messenger, peace be upon him. Do we fast 3 days in the month? That is the love of the messenger, peace be upon him. Do we start every day with the recitation of the Quran early in the morning before we leave the house? That is the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do we treat our family members with good words and respect? Do we fulfill our duties? Do we spend time with our family members? That is the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He being the best of creation, the most noble of all prophets of Allah, he used to help at home. He used to help the women folk at home with some of the chores of the house. Unfortunately, the men of today who claim to be the lovers of the same Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes they arrogantly would tell you, what did you just tell us to do? You mean I must go into the kitchen? La ilaha illallah. I'm not saying you should dwell there, but help, lend a good hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. I have spoken about the true love of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, starting with how, by saying his name, we should immediately utter sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If we were to say that, Allah will send blessings upon us tenfold. And this is why every time we hear the verses, and we shall hear them, and we continue hearing them, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs us to send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah bless every one of us. May Allah grant us goodness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our doors. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.